I'm interested in the way we tell stories about our lives, about the fact that the truth about the past is often ephemeral and difficult to pin down. And many of our stories, when we don't take proper time to do research about our pasts, which is almost always the case, end up with shifts and fictions in them, mostly unintended.
Storyteller is a documentary about the relationship of Diane Polly and Michael Polly. It's also about the revelation of an affair between Diane Polly and Harold Gherkin, the biological father of Sarah. For me, the most interesting part of this film is the exploration of truth and how Sarah Polly approaches it. She uses a Super 8mm camera to create home videos and footage for B-rolls and cutaways. Later on, she will go on to reveal the recreation and setup of the home videos. And to me, that's tremendously brilliant because it poses a question to the audience on the reliability of what we see. Throughout the film, I kept questioning the authenticity of the footage and I'm quite unsure of who or what to believe. Sarah Polly starts the recounting of the candid interviews with a raw approach. And at this point, the audience doesn't even consider what words may be reliable. It's a personal and private story and nobody has anything to gain by lying.
Like, who cares about our stupid family and...
And it goes on to the final part of the film where it explores the skewed side of documentaries.
What do you think of the concept of me making this documentary where we're sort of giving equal weight to everyone's version of the story?
I don't like it. I think that takes us into very woolly... Because you can't ever touch bottom with anything. Then we're all over the place. I think they can all be heard. It's giving them equal weight, which I find, particularly those who are non-players. One does not get the truth simply by hearing what their reactions are. People tend to declare themselves in terms of what they saw, in terms of what they felt, in terms of what they remembered, and in terms of their loyalties. The same set of circumstances will affect different people in different ways. Not that there are different truths. There are different reactions to particular events. The crucial function of art is to tell the truth, to find the truth in the situation. That's what it's about.
You realize when you've finished all this, you got about 6 hours of stuff, and you'll decide what you want out of it. It'll be exactly like the story. Each one of us will pick out, if any one of us were trying to edit it and decide what we wanted to keep, it would be the same farcical kind of theatrical exercise that we're all involved in. Oh, I want to keep that. Oh, that's rubbish. That's an enormously different thing from simply doing an interview straight and never doing any editing of it whatsoever, but letting it run as it is. That would have been at least as close to truth as you can get, whereas your editing of this will turn this into something completely different.
Both Harry Gherkin and Michael Polly is right. The filmmaking process is incredibly selective, and even if I'm given a vantage point, truth is not guaranteed.
So it's just weird that now when I interview people, like a couple of her close friends were shocked that Harry was my dad because they always thought you were my dad.
Well, okay, then I'll have to tell you that we did sleep together once.
I find this to be a perfect ending to Diane's story. This sentence has upset everything that's been established in the film. Harry Gherkin has been talking about how intense their love had been, but suddenly with Joss' statement, I have to question everything that Harry has said. So ultimately, what is stories we tell really trying to document? Perhaps in the most truthful way, Sarah Polly really was just interested in the stories we tell ourselves. Personally, I think as time passes, the truth matters less. The emotions and the memories a person leaves behind is far more important. Perhaps stories we tell is really what it suggests. The many and numerous colourful stories of Diane Polly.